Today, computers are all around us, from desktop computers to smartphones. They are changing the way we live our lives. But have you ever asked yourself, what exactly is a computer? A computer is an electronic device that manipulates information or data. The computer sees data as ones and zeros, but it knows how to combine them in more complex things, such as photograph, a movie, a website, a game, and much more. Computers use a combination of hardware and software. Hardware is any physical part of the computer, which includes all the internal components and also the external parts like the monitor and keyboard. Software is any set of instructions that tells the hardware what to do, such as a web browser, media player, or word processor. When people say computer, they are talking about a personal computer. This could be a desktop or a laptop, which is basically has the same capabilities, but more portable. Personal computers come in two main styles, PC and Mac. PCs are the most common type. They are made by different companies that make them and usually work with the Microsoft Windows operating system. Macs or Macintosh computers are made by one company, Apple, and they come with the Mac OS X operating system. Computers come in many other shapes and sizes, mobile phones, tablets, game consoles, and even TVs that have built-in computer. There is another type of computer that plays an important role in our life. Servers. A server serves information to other computers on a network. In fact, every time you use the internet, web server deliver the web page to your computer screen. Servers are also used in many offices to store and share files. As you can see, there are many different types of computers and they affect our lives in a variety of ways. Now let's see the different parts of a desktop computer. It is made up of several basic parts, and let's see what these parts are and what they are used for. The computer case contains the main components of the computer. This is where the actual processing happens. Today, most cases are tower cases, which means they stand up vertically. Sometimes you may see a horizontal case, which is often called a desktop case. In order to view anything on your computer, you will need a monitor. The monitor connects to the video card inside your computer to display images and text on the screen. Most monitors have LCD or LED displays, which can be made very thin and don't use much desk space. To save even more space, you can even buy an all-in-one computer which combines the monitor and computer case all in one unit. To interact with your computer, you will need a keyboard and mouse. Keyboard comes in different shapes and sizes, for example, ergonomic and wireless keyboards. The mouse is used to control the pointer on the screen. It can either be optical, which has an electrical eye at the bottom, or a mechanical, which uses a rolling ball to detect movement. Some people prefer to use a trackball or a touchpad instead of a mouse. These use less desk space. So these are some of the basic parts of the desktop computer. As you can see, every part plays an important role, and you will become very familiar with these parts as you gain more experience with the computer. Let us have a look inside the desktop. There are a lot of important parts inside the desktop. But what exactly do they do? Let's take a look inside and see the various components that make the computer work. Every computer has a large circuit board called the motherboard. This contains some of the important parts of the computer, such as the CPU, which is also called as the central processing unit or processor. The CPU is sometimes called the brain of the computer because it processes information and carries out commands. Since it tends to get hot, it is covered by the piece of metal called as a heatsink, which draws heat away from the processor. The motherboard also contains the RAM, or random access memory. This is the short-term memory the computer uses whenever it's performing calculations. For long-term storage, the computer uses the hard drive, which keeps all of its data even when the computer is turned off. Most hard drives uses a magnetic platter to sort data, but many new computers have solid-state drives, which are faster and more durable, but also more expensive. If you want to upgrade your computer, you can add expansion cards to your motherboard's expansion slots. You can add a video card to get better graphic performance, or you could add a wireless card to connect to your wireless home network. Your computer components need electricity to run. The power supply unit is designed to take the power supply from the wall unit and send it to all the components that need power. A desktop computer is a pretty complex machine, but now that you know what goes on inside, it should be pretty less mysterious. If you're thinking of buying a computer, you may have wondered, is a laptop right for me? Depending on how you plan to use it, the answer may be yes. Let's see how a laptop is different from a desktop to help you decide. The biggest difference is portability. Laptops have to be small and light so that you can pick them up and take them with you. Since all of the parts are built in, setting up a laptop is as easy as using it. The downside is that the monitor is usually smaller than a desktop monitor, so you will have less screen space. Another important difference is laptops use batteries. The battery can provide power to the laptop when you're on the go, and it will recharge whenever it is plugged in. Instead of a mouse, laptops usually have a built-in touchpad, also known as a trackpad. You can control the pointer on the screen by using a drawing motion with your finger. If you haven't used the touchpad before, the experience is a little bit different than using a mouse, and it may take a while to use this. If you're buying a desktop computer, you can mix and match almost any monitor, keyboard, and mouse that you want. With a laptop, you won't have quite as much as freedom, as everything is built in. However, if you want the best of both worlds, you can use your laptop ports to connect a separate monitor, keyboard, and mouse, basically turning your laptop into a desktop. And of course, whenever you want, you can simply disconnect everything and take your laptop with you. As you can see, there are some important differences between laptops and desktops. So, depending on your preference, you can decide which ones best suits your need.